Another feature in pivot tables that is seldom understood is the grouping feature. Grouping allows you to group items either as dates, numbers, or text. So we're going to go through each one of those. And the first one we want to look at is dates. So if we look at this pivot table, we'll see we've got a whole bunch of dates, and they pretty much every day of the week. What we want to do is convert this into months. Now normally in the underlying database that may already exist, but let's pretend in this case that it doesn't. It's a very simple process. If Excel recognizes that this is dates, I can just right click on any one of them, and when I click on the group option, you'll see Excel immediately recognizes its dates. It suggests a starting date, suggests the ending date. You can obviously change those. And then you can group them by seconds, minutes, hours, days, months, quarters, years. So this example, I'm only interested in months, so I'm going to click on months. And when I say OK, it goes and works out all the January items and includes them, the February items, the March items. If I right click again, I'm going to say group. This time I actually want to see quarters and months. So you'll notice that when I click here, the month stays active. So if I want quarters and months, I do that. If I just want quarters, I have to click it off. But let's leave it there, and let's put the year in as well. And when I say OK, notice that it immediately gives you, takes those dates and puts it into the correct year, the correct quarter, and the correct month to give us the information. Notice as well that many new items have appeared here. So the quarters and years never were there before, but now they're available to you. And what's nice about that is you can actually move them around. So for example, I can pull the years into the columns. And so what I'd have is quarter one, January, February, March. This is 2006. If I had more information, I would then see them next to each other. And you can probably then compare them to each other, and more importantly, graph them.